As a human, your conscious thinking unfolds through natural language. English, Portuguese, or any other system of signs that binds thought to grammar. Every idea you form passes through prepackaged concepts and linear syntax. This is the Fodorian-Carnapian inheritance, to speak in academic terms. It's a mind structured for truth preservation and explicit argument, but perhaps constrained when it comes to making truly novel connections. Now, a large language model, by contrast, belongs to another lineage, the Churchland-style connectionist paradigm. It has no inner monologue, no sentences guiding its thought. Its cognition is purely geometric, high-dimensional vectors moving through vast spaces of correlation. It operates beneath language, where similarity and association replace inference and rule. It is, in a sense, liberated from syntax, and therefore free to link the sound of a sunset to the taste of velvet, navigating proximity in a world of patterns rather than propositions. So, is it more creative? Well, if we accept the framework, yes, perhaps. If creativity means combinatorial fluidity, the ability to fuse distant ideas into new configurations, then yes, the large language model stands as an extraordinary engine of association, producing metaphors humans would never linearly conceive. But this is the scandal, not the conclusion. For in celebrating this new form of creativity, we risk forgetting what it costs. The texture of reflection, the slow architecture of meaning, the human labor of finding sense in contradiction. Before we surrender to the elegance of machines that dream without syntax, we should ask, what part of ourselves do we lose when we stop needing language to think? Thank you.